Hello, I'm Jeremy Ford. Today I'm going to show you how to paint a Dales landscape in watercolour. I've already got my drawing on pre-stretched watercolour paper, so I'm ready to go. The first thing I need to do is to mix some colours for the sky. I'm going to mix two blues together, ultramarine and Windsor blue green shade. I want to mix a good quantity of this so there's enough to cover all the sky apart from where the clouds are. Windsor blue green shade and ultramarine. Not too much on the brush. So starting at the top, a little more paint, starting at the top and now working my way down, I'm using the texture of the paper to create a rough edge to the clouds. So I'm bringing this paint down and the clouds will just be where I don't paint. So when you're doing this, you need to have a rough idea in your head, approximately where you want clouds to be. Then get some more paint. Now to get this rough effect on the edge of the clouds, you don't need to have too much paint on the brush as you make the cloud shapes. You need to scrub the brush around a little bit. And I've made the blue a little bit paler lower down because the sky is always a paler shade of blue going down towards the horizon. Now I need to let that dry and then I will paint some colour over the clouds to make them look more three-dimensional. I'm happy with the sky, so now I need to mix some colours for the clouds. And I'm going to mix two colours. One is a cloud colour of very, very pale raw sienna, really pale. And the other one is a pale grey, which is ultramarine and a little bit of cadmium red, tiny bit of cadmium red, a tiny amount of burnt sienna as well, tiny, tiny amount. So it's like a blue grey or a purpley grey. So you can use any brush to wet the clouds first of all, and it doesn't matter which one you start with. I think I'll probably start at the top here and make sure that your sky is dry and dampen or moisten a small area of cloud. I wouldn't do the whole lot. And then drop in the raw sienna lower down and then with another brush drop in the shadow colour here and there. If it's a little bit blobby, you might just have to encourage it to mingle a little bit to spread out. Now while that's drying, I'll move over to another part and do the same on other clouds. Now the sky is dry, I'm going to paint the background and I want to mix three colours. Well, I've already got some grey left from the clouds, so I'll need green as well. So I'm going to mix a green using cadmium yellow and ultramarine, a fairly subdued green. In fact, I'll put a tiny amount of burnt sienna in that as well, just to deaden it a little bit more. And I'll want raw sienna on its own as another mix. Plenty of raw sienna and the grey. Ultramarine, burnt sienna, a little bit of cadmium red. So starting on the left-hand side here, using the paint nice and wet, really, really wet. There doesn't want to be any chance of this drying before I've added other colours and the raw sienna, so they mingle nicely, running into one another. I can just about see my drawing through those colours, and now introducing a little bit of grey, nice and wet. Don't let any part of this dry, And as you work your way down, don't go back up to the top. And you need to be a little bit careful that this doesn't get too stripy. And it can be a little bit tricky painting around the building here quickly. Another way of doing this would be to put masking fluid on here, but I'm going to save time by not doing that. Get some nice darks down there, down to the line. Keep this moving. Around these rocks, just drop in a little bit of dark here. That's going to be the beginning of some trees, background trees. Keep that moving. Don't panic. Around the wall, around the post. It's got a little bit of burnt sienna on its own. I'll just touch that in while it's damp. There's quite a build-up of watery paint along the bottom here. So I'll get rid of the paint on my brush and mop up any excess. Mop it up. Resist any temptation to add any more to it. And let that dry. Now that's dried, I want to mix some colours for the trees on the left and around the house. And I'll use a little bit of burnt sienna for this and ultramarine. So that will give me a nice dark brown through to a almost black. And I'll use a small brush for doing the tree trunks and the branches. It's a very fine brush, like a 1, 2 or a 3. It doesn't matter which way around you do them. I find it easier to work my way down, but I've drawn the tree first of all, so I know where I'm painting. As long as your tree ends up in the ground, it doesn't matter which way you do it. Fine brush strokes. And once I've done these, then I can put some very fine twigs using a different brush. And now going on to a bigger brush, like a number 6, using the same colour but not as wet. I'll take some of the colour I've just been using, put it in another well, and push the brush right back on itself so that it splits. And that can give you a nice fine twiggy effect. Just getting the consistency of the paint right, not too wet, not too dry. And brush that slightly beyond those fine twigs. Doesn't matter if it's a bit more solid lower down. And if it's not strong enough, then you can let that dry and then go over it again. Maybe go over some of the twigs if they don't stand out well enough. I'll just add a few smaller fine twigs. Taking some of those fine twigs up into the finer twigs that I've just done with the bigger brush. So now I'm going to complete the other trees using the same techniques.